I might can't get him, but I can get 99 for other people. So that means numbers don't lie. That means I'm ahead of the game in spite of the L, which I'm not ever going to be comfortable with, but it is what it is, right? But 99% of y'all, I can get. And most media know that. When they start hearing Chavez and Hopkins, Triple G and Hopkins, a little dangerous, we'll wait, travel fight. That's the only thing they want to know. We'll wait. Well, you come up, I come down. I'm not a big light heavyweight. You seen my last fight. Did I look bigger than Kovalev? Did he look bigger than me? It looked like a cruiserweight versus a middleweight. I'm not making justifiable excuses. I'm just telling you, look at your teammate. It's a big guy. Okay. Most light heavyweights, if not all, they train down to 75. So that means they train down to 75. They come down from 200. 95. That's why the cruiserweight division moves to 200 pounds, then 90 pounds. I come down from 83, 82. I never let my, I can't gain it. His pants are a little tight, but it's okay. They're 32 inch waist. But my intelligence and my defense that played a big role in that last fight. Awesome, man. 49. Got through 20 punches and got one or two in.
One or two. He wasn't supposed to get hit. He wasn't supposed to get hurt, but he got hurt by you. How did it happen?
Ninth round. It's, oh, you ready to do it again? You see that right here? Right? Smart. Brad, Dillian, best thing to do. But I built such a reputation. Justified. Reputation. Count Bernard Hopkins out until the bell ends. I'm not gonna get knocked out. We need fighters that have that same venom and that same spirit, that take the fights, not listen to advisors and all these other people sitting back looking out for themselves first, under the disguise of looking out for the fighters, and tell them that they should not fight this guy, that they should fight that guy, because if they come first in disguise of the fighters, enter. I've seen it, I've been there, done that. So when fighters now in any division, in boxing, and this is when I become not the policeman in boxing, but I become a pain in the ass and some of cancer. Because I'm saying out to the fellow fighters, whether you're with us or not with us, I'm setting the stage that give y'all right now Pacquiao and Kovalev. Because Pacquiao and Kovalev understands, at least Pacquiao understands, that hey, Bernard Hopkins stepped up. Made him step up from our 14th. Yeah. So we now start to see a movement. That's what I've been doing in my career. I've been the Satchel Paige in boxing. I've been the guy of the Jim Browns and the Bill Russells in their era when they said, wait a minute, I'm playing for y'all. We black, y'all calling us these names? It takes one person to say, I'm not sitting on the front bus. I'm sitting in the back. I'm sitting on the front. And to change the game, that means you can ride on the front bus.
Open it up.
They might not like it today, but we still can. It took somebody that had the fortitude and the guts. And so now, in losing, I win. In losing, I win. You know why? The burden was on me. The burden was on that 19-year-old guy that's been doing what you've been doing and everybody else that's your age, knocking them out. So I win, and I come out with not a scar. And I come out with my vocabulary, my voice, my talk. Look, there's people that hate that. They want to see me walking around. I'm coming to Gleason's, and y'all hold me up. Look, help me. Right, that's a shame. He shouldn't. No, he shouldn't. We got the champion. We told him he shouldn't have boxed too long. They waiting. They thought they had the guy in November 8th. And remember, no, I didn't win. But they didn't want to see what benefits me. Some, not all. The burden ain't on me. The burden is on a 20-year-old guy.
It's going to be like that.
You see how I win? The law is great, ain't it? You win, you lose, but you win. And that's why I got more feedback.
You won a long time ago, bro.
I won a long time ago, yeah, absolutely. That's why I get a lot of feedback. No
sympathy conversation for people. You inspire me, brothers. Black, white, Jewish, Muslim, Hebrew, Buddhist. When I travel through cities around the world and outside of Philly, New York, whatever, you inspire me. Ladies, 60, 70, I eat better than them because I read the story on the New York Times, the 5 pages article that mainstream media looked at and watched. People with money read those magazines. You inspire me. I stop eating butter, take a little olive oil. I read your... This is non-boxing, but they understand. They would never defeat this. The spirit. The man. They would never defeat it. And losing, I win. And today, you got a 49-year-old, fast to be 50, January 15th. Still relevant. Still relevant. Correct me if I said something wrong. This man just said he wants to see me fight again. He's been around long enough to not have an eye problem. And I think he's mad enough to tell me that out of respect, not to say I want to see you fight the same because I've been around him. We might disagree and agree in the past. But he understands that, yo, right now, from November 8th, you still got fighting. And he's right. But it has to be not right per se, but it has to be something I want to do. If it was about money, it has to be right that way. But it ain't about that with me because I can grab a check and go in there and get what happened to me, what I always avoided, is I'm going in for the wrong reason. I never go in a situation for the wrong reason. And the wrong reason the last time I remember doing that is when I did the 5 days at the penitentiary. Go in a situation and the wrong reason is never good. It's never good. It has to be for the right reason. And the right reason, if I want to do a show, say goodbye to my fans, if I want to be the Bootsy Collins or Marvin Gaye or the famous group, and say you got one more time to see this favorite rock band that you might like or you might not like, or R&B or whatever, you got last time to see this group or this solo artist, one last time, come see me when that time comes, if it be that way. That's how I will celebrate, and that's how I will be celebrated, and that's how I will want it. There will be a situation, if I do, that I want anybody that can get there to see the last time, see the Beatles, if you like the Beatles, if you like the OGs, if you like the Jacksons now, the Jacksons back then. This is the time to come see it, buy your ticket. That's how I would want to be leaving out of the game. On that level, not a level of microphone, win or lose, what are you going to do, Bernard? Well, I'm not going to cheapen myself and retire on TV. See, the ring normally retires the ones that stay around too late. But me and the ring has not a deal. We have an understanding that those rules don't apply to me. Because I'm smart enough to leave out before I get burnt. That's always been my thing.
You know your limits.
I definitely know my limits.
Other people don't.
Well, other people want to put limits on you. Other people do know what they think your limits are. And they put limitations on you. And it's up to us in business, in sport, in life, to prove wrong that they might think you know or don't know or do or don't do. That's all been my makeup.
You keep proving them wrong.
I just wanted to come out. Listen, who thought? My whole objective was to come out in 1988 out of the penitentiary, Brady Ford State Penitentiary. It's like Broadway in New Jersey. And stay out of trouble and walk off this 9 years poor. Now, all this ain't not an accident that happened, obviously, because hard work pays off. That was my whole idea. How the hell I'm going to stay out of jail in 1988 to the 90s in the drug crack era where everybody's getting money and nobody's working? That was my whole objective. That's when I became champion, when I did that. When I gave 9 years on the street without a parking ticket.
That's your move.
That's when I became world champion. They think it was when I beat 95, when I beat Segundo Mercado, when I beat Tito in 2001, post 9/11. They thought I was when I beat Oscar. No, I didn't become champion then. I go deep. I take it back. I became champion. And some can understand that. Some be like, oh, wait a minute, that's pretty deep. at some New Jacks from the city. He said, well, I ain't know that happened. I said, yeah, that's why I became champion. To me, in my mind, I got the belt then. I said, all this other stuff was just extra. I just went above beyond people's expectations.
Hockey here is a role model.
I'm pretty deep, man. I got some form. I got some form at this game. I'm in something else. I'm in the whole trip or something else. Watch.
I'm wondering if
the vocabulary in my senses is still intact.
You maybe could encourage Pacquiao when he comes to that table to find that common ground and make that fight. I'm wondering if you're stepping up the fight. But maybe being in for
as far as Pacquiao and Mayweather.
I think that
smart business people and understanding will come to their minds to be able to do what it takes to make the fight happen. I think it's a lot at stake financially, and it's a lot at stake historically in boxing. So like anything, I think that the role play and the foreplay has wind down to now real talk and real business. Whatever, 4 or 5 years of whether they're going to fight or not going to fight, I think it's coming to the head, whether it's going to be or not. I think it's coming to the point now that it is. And one key thing is the fans has the power. You know why? Because at that level, and you bank it on getting certain numbers where everybody's happy versus the networks. They want to recoup some of their money, if not all. And they definitely want to make a profit for the bonus. When you got people churning off, those TVs are not buying those pay-per-views, and they sending a message. And they sending a message that, you know, we'd rather see you fight this person than that person. Then we're going to show our power and our voice by not buying the fight. And so the fans are catching on. The fans should never be underestimated. You know, some people in boxing do. I don't. Because I know that they really are the power brokers when it comes to whether you can sell a fight or whether you can promote a fight and get the results at the end. And they call numbers. And they call how they recruit, what they put out. So put out investment to build the big fight. And if nobody tune in, it's a bad investment. They don't recover. And so the fans now are saying to Floyd and to the boxers that's called themselves the best, listen, you can fight whoever you want to fight, whether it's American or anybody else, and all these good fighters working to be great. But we're going to show you that what you're expecting to get, 1.2, 2 million viewers, 1 million viewers, we're not going to get it. So when you see a fight happen, and you don't see them run out the numbers of what the fight did on pay-per-view, that tells you that it ain't do well. Breaking even is not doing well. I got over 50 whoppers in the Philippines. I know that breaking even is nothing you celebrate. Right? You're not totally bummed out, but you're not celebrating. I believe the fight has a 50-50 chance for happening. Based on some personal agendas on each side that haven't been cleared up in this new fight. Because I believe Pacquiao wants to fight Mayweather, and I believe Mayweather wants to fight Pacquiao. To prove that you can beat him now, and you can beat him way before we start really seriously talking about it. And I want to see the fight. I want to see the fight. I want to see the fight 4 years ago, 3 years ago, and I want to see the fight even now. And I believe it's going to happen. See, listen, both guys really want to.